is inside it. I don't know if you've seen the new King Stone poll data, but it's very good. There's a nice trend to those numbers.
Yes, I like that. Isn't that funny?
I'm waiting, Bob.
I've just been trying to find the liver transplant.
Not for himself.
Now there's one baby and I had COVID.
Once again, let's get the photo.
I managed to get a plane flat out there to the hospital. No one's come up, no donors come up yet. Liver transplant, so I think maybe if we get our names in the paper again about it, maybe we'll get the word out that there's one needed. That's if I was on the hill, I'd like to see offer.
All right. Mr. President, when you extended the commission on June 10th, you also asked that the commission come together and give you any further ideas it may have an implementation of their earlier recommendations. And so I believe we had a meeting today, Brandon.
We're going to have.
We'll have.
We will have.
Well, I want to thank you all for agreeing to do that. I know that you didn't know that you signed on for the whole war instead of just one battle. I am grateful to you. And I have issued some suggestions for guidance on the basis of that to the Department of Defense on the high priority of command and control and communications for our strategic forces and continued modernization of the bomber force and the Trident 2D5 missile and Trident submarine program to expand research and development with regard to defense against ballistic missiles and to deploy the 100 as everyone had agreed and to immediately initiate the design of the idea for a small single warhead ICBM, and for its probable deployment late in the decade or early in the next, and all the things that you've recommended about the uncertainties about silo and shelter hardness and fratricide and all, and Cap hasn't argued with me a bit on any of those points. In letters and comments to Congress, every time I've had the chance, I've made the points about that we want to reduce the overall force levels and that modernization is essential if we're to do that and do it practically. And we've also talked to modifications of the START proposals as were suggested, and I have notified General Romney on the START talks there of new flexibility that he had. Now we have abandoned as a result the 850 missile idea, but we still believe and hold into and trying for the 5,000 warhead limit overall. Limit, and he had
carpet.
Mr. President, why did you feel it was necessary to personally instruct your staff to cooperate with the Justice Department?
Well, no, I tell you, don't take questions here, press on photo opportunity, but I'll be seeing you outside the door over there on my way to the helicopter in a little while, on the way to Camp David, and I will stop. You won't forget the question.
Vice, please.
Thank you.
Hello there.
Good to see you.
Yes, good to see you.
We're very happy to be here, and you know, Jean first.
Jean first, very nervous.
Yes, how are you?
Mrs. Mason.
Hello there.
Nice to meet you, James.
James, hello, how are you? Good to see you.
That was cut out, put it back in, and showed it to 6,000 people last night.
That was wonderful.
And it was glorious.
It was magic.
Where does this time, because I had that, somebody did something with a print of an old picture of mine, and brought it. Is this that it's lost in this TV showings now?
No, it wasn't that. It was when they, well, it's not exactly.
No, it was cut.
What happened in this case was that they had a previous, a preview of, you know, one of those places. And it was about 3.5 hours long, you see, and at that time they thought, Harry Warner.
Not Jack.
We remember when they had to get
off. They wanted to get back for him.
We just talked about that all the time, right?
And so after this very successful, people came back and said, oh, wow, it's great, it's lovely. And then surprise, surprise, they cut half an hour, at least half an hour, I think more than that, 4 minutes or so, out of it, never to be seen again. And then, worse than that, they boiled it down for the silver. But yes, this, you know, this
they
is 1953, it's not during
the
war, anything like that.
But we had a hunch that if we could get into Warner's Falls, I'm sure you'd like to get into Warner's Falls too, that we could find a lot of it, and we did. We found outtakes and enough to put back a half hour of it.
Wow.
And it changes the film.
That's
it gives
great.
The film real
taste.
Listen, I know. Why don't we
do some individuals
shot here as a group, and then why we have a shot?
Oh, good. Right, absolutely.
Maybe move over a little bit
all
so
right.
No one behind the lamp.
All right.
Especially not that gentleman.
Especially not really that
gentleman.
You're that way, James.
Okay,
why don't
you
just
have
one with James.
All right.
Yes.
All right. You know, we're not supposed to look in the camera except now we are. Thank you, sir. Yes, now. Yes, why don't you get in the middle?
Oh, all right. Okay. By two great men.
I have to tell you my story about this.
Let's get my
father.
We need one more individual right here.
And Faye is going to get the one on here.
All right.
Just with the president.
Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you. I have to tell you what, Father Hesper from Notre Dame brought a print of the Rockne film to me and claimed it's one of the only two left that have not lost so much through cutting them for commercials and TV and the distribution. But they had two prints because of Notre Dame. They still run that film as an indoctrination for the incoming freshman.
Oh, that's awesome.
So they brought and gave me a print of this film. We ran it here. But my favorite story has to do with that picture. There was a fella who had a small part in that picture. This happened in Hollywood. And he knew it was going to be run on television one night. And this was some years ago. And he knew the cutter at the TV studio. And I had never known this, but right down till it goes on the air, the salesmen are bringing in spot ads. And out goes a minute of film to put it on the air. So he said, oh boy, he said, be sure to leave this little bit of mine in, because he said, I've got a producer looking at it. It may mean a job for me. Well, it went out and in the cutting. And the next day he called the film editor and he said, you know, I asked you to and so forth and so on. And the film editor says, look, they were bringing in so many ads. He says, Gibbs' 80-yard run turned out to be a 5-yard loss.
I love it. Wow.
Oh, isn't that wonderful?
Listen, we better ask
respond to Hesper, he may have some, he might have an original copy of a Star Is Born.
I doubt that Notre Dame would have.
I love that. Oh, isn't that 85 yard, the Ingram 5 yard loss.
Well, that's, now is that going to be in general release?
No, we're not sure. Warner's did it for us for the Academy, allowed us to go in and search for it for a year and do it as a gesture toward preservation of film, which is this big launch we're all doing, and your director is very interested in, you know, the new head of the NEA. But I think now, if they were, and they were present last night at the reception of that film by that audience, a standing ovation, everyone just dissolved. I think people want to see movies about people.
Yeah.
It's about people.
Yeah.
I think they will.
We are bringing it to Washington tomorrow night at the Warner Theater.
The Warner.
And it's selected cities around the country.
It's going, yes, to 6 cities.
But we're working with Frank Hotzel, Faye and I, on this whole preservation
effort. Too much for the print run, then one day we'll put it in a report.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
And you will love it. You will love it.
I did.
The
first version of it, I have to tell you, almost turned me around on a long drive. I was a sports announcer in Iowa, and was wired that I had a contract offer from Warner Brothers for pictures, and got in my car and started the long drive out to Hollywood from Des Moines, Iowa. And the first night out I stopped was in Cheyenne, Wyoming, and it was the first version of A Star Is Born.
Is that
it was in the movie there. And I went to the movies, and I came home back to the hotel, I mean, and I said, should I turn around and go back? I wasn't quite sure I wanted to go the rest of the way.
You mean you really saw the disintegration?
It was very good. I thought it was a better actual overall look at the story than ours was, really.
It's a dramatic one of game, isn't it?
Yeah. And Frederick
March.
Yes.
I think this is the quintessential.
Well, I love this one.
Me too.
This president, I need to move us along, but you've got another appointment where
I wonder why.
He's having more fun here.
I want it on the set.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Good to see you. Good time. Well.
Thank you. Goodbye.
We'll see that you all get these pictures.
We appreciate that.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Thank you.